Brett, I'm a huge fan of the series. You've managed to finish Uncharted 4?
Yep.
What do you make of it? No spoilers.
No, I promise there won't be any spoilers in this. It is undoubtedly a fantastic game and the best one in the series, and honestly, absolutely jaw-dropping to play. There were so many times when I hit the share button on the PS4 pad just to grab screenshots.
That's awesome.
And I've got an entire library on my console now of just screenshots of the game. It's so beautiful to play. You just stop and you just look and just look around, pan the camera, and you just stand there. There's a great thing in the game where it tells you time spent standing still, and that's purely because I'm just panning the camera around and looking at the environment. It's so beautiful. And then when it was, you know, Uncharted is great for those sort of cartoonish reactions to grenades. There's some great moments when you see a guy just being flipped from a grenade. It's perfect in that regard.
Full of those awesome moments.
Yeah. There's a beautiful thing that the game does where there's no load times. There'll be a load just at the beginning of the game just to get you in, but there's such a beautiful transition between cutscene and in-game. There's a difference between how good it looks in cutscene and when you're playing it, but it's so subtle because it looks so good while you're playing it, so you don't really notice, but it's so good to look at and to play. It's so smooth as well.
Is it a big step up over the last one? Because I guess Uncharted 3 was PS3, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But then they remastered it. Have you played it on the PS4?
Yeah, the Nathan Drake collection. Because obviously they've got the assets, there's only so much I can do in terms of touching them up and sort of beautifying them a little bit. This one, because it's been done from the ground up, honestly, the lighting effects, it's one of those where in low light it looks stunning, in daylight it also looks gorgeous as well. The great thing about Naughty Dog is that they know what they can do and they know what the limitations are. They're fantastic directors. Strady and Druckmann, they know exactly how to guide the player, and they also know when to take a pause in the game and just say, look, here you go, here's some gameplay for you. Just take a break from all the heart racing, the chase scenes, and just explore the world. There's some more sandbox areas in this game where you can, you know, there's more a sense of, you can go left, you can go right, you can go straight forward. It's a bit forced in that regard. You know, we're used to just going straight.
I was gonna say, how linear is this? All these games are very just set path. You can't really go out of your way anywhere. Is it a bit more open, this one?
Yeah, Stuart Andrews, in our written review on the website, he describes this really well in that as much as they want to create these sandbox areas where basically you'll come to an area in the game, and in previous Uncharted, it will simply be, okay, you've got a linear path. You can either go up, traverse upwards and go, or you can just walk straight forward. Here it's much more open. You'll have a large desert area, you'll have a wide open expanse, you'll have multiple paths, and they're very deliberately marked for you. You can see trodden paths, left, right, straight ahead. And it does feel like a sense of, okay, our criticism in the past is there's only one way forward, so let's just stick in two more.
He still kills a lot of people as well, I guess.
Oh yeah, he's a mass murderer. Let's not confuse things. He's a nice guy. Kills untold people in this game. You feel bad at some points as well, because you know the sneaking missions that you get where you can start off sneaking around? They're back and they're done a lot better. They're a lot smoother.
I was going to say, that was like the worst bit of Uncharted.
Yeah. They definitely felt shoehorned in Uncharted 3, but here they're implemented a lot better. There's some funny moments where a guard, you'll walk up behind someone, you think, oh, okay, I'll just, you know, like in 3, you think, I can choke him out. Here, you'll press a button and you see it, neck, snap. You say, oh, no, that was what I wanted. The fight will inevitably end up in a gunfight, but you just enjoy it for the start. You try and take out as many enemies as you can before the shooting starts, and it is good for that.
So how long did it take you to finish?
Well, this is the thing. It was I got about 9 or 10 hours in, and I thought, okay, I'm getting to the third act now. There was a clearly marked moment where I thought, this is the transition, I'm getting to the end stretch. And that final few moments, what I thought were, lasted a good 5 hours more.
That's and pretty good though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a fantastic campaign, honestly. And every single actor in that game gives an outstanding performance. And again, it helps to know who these people are, who these characters are across the whole journey, because when they turn up, you think, oh, I remember you, oh, yeah. I love you. And Troy Baker as well, coming into this series in the final entry, is fantastic as Drake's brother Sam. He's so good.
So it's also like 15 hours, maybe 14?
Yeah, about that, yeah.
That's a pretty solid campaign.
Yeah, and again, for an action game as well, where you need so many of these chase scenes and these
heart stops.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And it's got so many excellent ones, and to look as stunning as they do, to all fit as well, it's brilliant.
That sounds awesome. I can't wait to play it. And what happens at the end?
Ready for spoilers now? Here we go.